Hi guys, it's Genna. I'm back to make my husband eat weird crap.
I shouldn't have told you I was feeling better. Now I'm gonna deal with this crap again. Ugh.
Stroop waffles!
I mean, that might be okay. I heard there's there might be a box. We've got a lot of boxes. There's a box from my home country somewhere.
Somewhere, but for now, Netherlands.
Oh, great.
You sound disappointed.
Well, I mean, they're called the Netherlands, for God's sake. That either means one of two things. Either it's some hellspawn dimension, or it's talking about my balls. One way or the other, you probably shouldn't name a country that way. Just...
They didn't. It was Holland.
Well, it's Holland's fault then. Holland are idiots. Why are we even Holland? Okay. What is this? Original Holland toast. This is not toast. I'm just checking the date on this, because I want to make sure it's not poisonous. It feels like a sponge. What is this? What does one... Why can't you just have regular normal toast, like normal people?
Maybe you would have eggs on it.
There's
an egg on the thing. Is that an egg?
Yeah. So it's kind of like used as a sort of little sandwich thing, I guess.
It looks like a crostini.
Yeah, it does. It looks kind of like a crostini. But apparently this is original Holland toast.
Does Holland have a flavor? Does it taste like Holland?
Probably bland, I imagine, if it's Holland. Let's have a look. It's a piece of toast.
It actually looks kind of cute.
I mean, yeah, you could probably eat some of this.
Would you put an egg on it? Like an over easy egg, do you think?
I've never eaten a more boring piece of food in my life.
No way!
Hey, I love bland food, but... Man,
not even with like butter or jam or something?
I mean, you'd have to put quite a lot on this to... you know, this exists like solely for texture, I think. Like,
yeah, but do you think maybe it's like for an appetizer, like to put like, you know, cheese and meats or something
well,
on
what,
it?
Well, what, I mean, the cheese and meats and tomatoes that are on there? Yeah, probably.
That's not meat, is
There's
it?
There's cheese and tomato and scallions.
Oh.
Yeah, so this has no flavor of its own, basically. The purpose, I imagine, is to add texture to kind of little sort of snack sandwiches, things like that.
It's quite sizable.
I mean, you can put a piece, not that big, you can maybe put an egg on there if you're lucky, yeah. I mean, yeah, I can see the purpose of it. On its own, though, it sucks. Like, it's maybe the most boring food I've ever put in my mouth.
So you don't think it's a
It's
snack.
Also really, really dry.
It's not snack, no?
Not on its own, no way.
Okay.
It's like the people that eat Ryvita, like, without anything on it. Those weird people.
They like to grate their insides, is what I'm told.
Those people need to be in jail. Alright, Mella. Chocolate caramel chews.
That sounds good.
I don't see the problem with this, yep. As long as I haven't had, I've had good food in Holland. You know, I've been to Holland.
Have you been?
I have. I've been to Holland.
Until you've had like stroopwafels off of the actual street vendors, you have not lived. What do you think?
Yeah, it's pretty good. It reminds me of Cadbury's Eclairs.
Ooh.
Actually very similar to that, just a different shape. Yeah. I mean, not like exploding in flavor or anything, but it's alright.
Netherlands, exploding in flavor.
No one has ever said that in the history of the world.
And they never will again, right?
No. Another big box. Kass Domino. Dag eins Einsteinsgebüsch.
I'm sorry, did you German what?
Wenn ihr würd, that's not even a real word. You guys are making this up. These look also equally dull. There's a piece of cheese on there. It looks exactly like...
cheese flavored or...?
I hope not. Because, I mean, these look really similar to something we've got in the UK, which are these kind of layered wafer biscuits.
Yeah, I know. But I think they might be cheese flavored.
That might be the worst thing to ever happen.
Why?
Let's find out. I don't like cheese flavoring. Like, I like cheese. Like, real cheese. But cheese flavored stuff is usually terrible. I guess we'll find out. Oh god. Yeah, so they are basically little wafer biscuits.
Mm-hmm.
Please don't be cheese.
I bet it's cheese. Is it cheese?
Oh god.
It's cheese, isn't it?
Oh, that's the worst.
Is it cheese?
It's cheese. It's a cheese powder.
Ah.
Melting cheese type gouda. No, it is not. Oh.
So it's like some powdered Gouda wannabe?
Why would you make that? Oh, dear. Yeah, I'm not a fan of those in the slightest. And cheese flavoring is usually terrible, and that is no exception to that rule. Right, that is, yeah, no, mm-mm. Oh, I've had this before. When I went to Holland years ago for their first look game event, for breakfast one time, these are designed to go on toast.
Oh.
It's breakfast chocolate.
So it's the flakes.
Yeah. Chocolate flakes.
Maybe you should put them on your
Maybe I should put them on the Holland toast. Maybe they will taste better if I add the chocolate flakes. Because yeah, I remember we had like butter on it and then chocolate flakes, I think.
That Wookiee cleavage though.
Get out. Jeez, you pervert. It's PG-13 rated. Can't have that. Quite a bit better now. Still kind of bland, but yeah, breakfast flaking chocolate is an odd thing, but they do that in Holland and it's pretty cool. All right. It's a mint.
It's a mint?
It's a mint. Wilhelmina Peppermint. I mean, it's a mint. What?
Do you want to have that at the end, like an after dinner mint?
Yeah, that'll be a palate cleanser. We're going to have that.
Yeah.
Instead, oh, it's another mint. King Peppermint. We're keeping the mints to the end. Palate cleanser. Croaky, 100% loud.
What?
These are apparently paprika flavored.
Ooh.
Never been the world's biggest fan of paprika, but we'll go with it. Yep, smells like paprika, all that. That's pretty good. Yeah, I'd eat those. Definitely. That's actually quite nice. It's like, eat a balanced, varied diet, it says on the back. I call this varied, because it's very varied. Absolutely. Yeah, that's all right. You're gonna steal those now. You've got to show them, at least show them what they are.
They're mine. Here, you can have one.
Stroop waffles, yes.
Stroop waffles are
we were
super
given
legit.
Like about 5 kilos of these when
I
we went to Foxconn.
So
a bunch
much.
Of people came over from the Netherlands to our show and
not a bunch.
That's quite. There was a few.
Yeah, but you make
one
it sound
guy
like,
in particular. Yeah,
you make it sound like oh my god.
Yeah, one guy in particular who's actually telling me about his battle with leukemia. Actually,
yeah.
He's a really cool guy. We drank for quite some time. Yes, he brought us all of these. These are weigh a ton. They are cloyy. Generally, they're very thick and sweet.
Well, you don't eat them right. Yeah. Like you're not even eating them right. One, you have two of them, and for two, you.
That's why I eat like a sandwich.
You're supposed to like put them over top of a cup of coffee or a cup of tea. And,
yeah.
And.
But I don't like either of those things, so it's okay. It's fine. You can have the rest of it.
You're doing it all wrong.
Yeah, but I don't have a coffee or tea yet. I'll put it over. Let's dip it in apple juice. There we go. No, that's a terrible idea.
What's wrong with you?
Yeah, but yeah, stroop waffles are good.
Mine.
But you like them more than I do.
I do.
This on the other hand looks pretty cool. It is a cookie, a Drost cookie. It just looks like a butter biscuit.
You're a butter biscuit.
I love butter biscuits. You ain't having this. This is probably going to be legit as hell. Assuming it doesn't have nuts in it, which it looks like it might have. Ingredients: sulke, kakao butter, milk powder.
You're welcome, internet.
Kakao masa, biscuit. Okay. It is 10% biscuit. Butter, tarwist meal. More milk powder. Is that more milk powder? Like, Zoet. Rischmedelen. Vodigzar. Of course, naturally.
Can I make videos of you just doing this?
No.
No, I mean, like, not even eating anything. Just.
No,
saying.
I want to try and keep some self-respect. It actually hasn't been English yet. Yeah.
What are you doing then?
I'm mostly wasting time for more YouTube red revenue. Let's try the biscuit. Because that looks awesome. It better look, it tastes as good as it looks. Damn. Oh, great. That is mine. You're not having that.
I don't even get to try it.
Nope.
What?
Nope.
It's got nuts in it. Isn't that nuts?
Well, there's no nuts in that. Oh. No. It's biscuit pieces.
Biscuit.
It's mostly chocolate, actually. That's great.
He won't even let me try it.
No, you're not having it. It's mine. You've got the stroop waffles. Screw you.
But
you get to make money off me eating unhealthy crap, so the least you can do is let me have the biscuit. Alright, what do we got?
I want the biscuit, I just want to try the biscuit.
Nope. You can't have it. This is coffee raid maker Hodgepill, apparently. I assume this is some kind of coffee tablet. Yeah, it's a hard coffee. Sweet. which is actually surprisingly nice. Another weird thing about me is I like coffee flavored things, but not coffee itself. Except if it's iced coffee, in which case I will drink it, assuming it has enough milk in it.
But unfortunately, you will not have tea flavored things, despite the fact that you don't drink tea.
Well, I don't like tea or tea flavor.
There's something severely wrong with you.
I like green tea flavor, but not green tea.
And I will need all of your British documentation.
I left years ago. I don't care about that anymore. They're rubbish. Cameron ruined the country. Here is a windmill cookie from the Dutch bakery. It is a Dutch spiced cookie with a windmill on it. Nobody is surprised by this. Let's see if I shall tilt at this windmill. It's actually kind of broken, which is unfortunate because it's a little arty. Yeah. Okay. Pretty much gingerbread, basically. Kind of gingery flavor. It is extremely dry. That would be something I would probably dip in a drink if I were the kind of person to do that. I would not eat that on its own. It would dry my mouth out like the Sahara Desert. It's all right, though. Bit bland. There's actually several of these. This is a mint, isn't it? How many do you need? Like, they're all mints.
A mint? It looks like candy.
Well, yeah, but I think it's mint. I might be wrong, though. It's just called a Napoleon. I'm not sure what that has to do with a pink ball of sugar, but okay. And I can't open it. Because I'm terrible. Alright, here we go. Way too much hard candy, or whatever it is. It takes ages to get through this. Yes, this pink ball of whatever.
It's a Napoleon raspberry wine ball. So that is not a mint.
No, it's not a mint. It's actually surprisingly good. Yeah, I can definitely like taste a kind of little bit of white wine in it, I think. We have something extremely similar to this in the UK. I can't remember what it's called though. Damn, what was it? It's like one of those fruity polos. That's what it is.
So apparently, according to the guide that we have, it actually tells you, the Holland toast that we used. You're so actually supposed to use the rusk and the bread sprinkles together, and it gives you like this entire breakdown of like how you're supposed to do it and everything. We didn't read that because this is just a, hey, let's open this box and taste this sort of thing, but that's kind of interesting. Apparently you're supposed to spread a thin layer of butter on the top of it and then pour the sprinkles on top. And
yeah, because it makes the sprinkles stick.
Ah.
Yeah, so yeah. We had that for breakfast, but we just had it with real toast instead of those little things.
But apparently it's tasty enough to eat plain.
That is not in any way true. You will lie to us. Advocat is what this is. Well, it's some kind of
sugar, eggs, vanilla cream, and brandy. So it's like eggnog, basically. Well, I don't think I've ever had eggnog. I'm not a fan of eggnog, but you might be.
I guess we'll have to find out. Turns out I'm very much not. I have eggnog.
Oops.
No. Oh, God. I just got the brandy. That's terrible. Oh, God. No.
I get an idea. Let's wash it down with apple juice.
Yeah, that's probably a decent plan, actually. No. Absolutely not. That is the worst. Why would you invent that? Holland, I don't understand how you haven't been invaded.
How does it stack up to the Finnish licorice?
I mean, I'll take that over the Finnish licorice, but then again, I'd probably take a bullet to the brain over the Finnish licorice. So
heck yeah, Finland, still winning.
And other than the mints, which we probably won't eat because they're mints. Like, who cares about mints? That's another coffee one. Yeah, that's pretty much it, other than the mints. I guess I'll have a mint as a palate cleanser. And we can either have a King mint or a Wilhelmina mint. Which one should we have?
The King ones are supposed to be not too minty and not too sweet.
Well, what's the point then? I'll have the Wilhelm one.
The Wilhelmina one?
Oh, God. It's chalky.
Yeah.
It's like a coin. It's actually like... I think it's got their queen's head on it or something.
The Dutch princess, Wilhelmina. That's why they're Wilhelmina mints.
Yeah. These are...
Apparently there's a big debate between which mint is better, the Wilhelmina ones or the King ones, because it's basically like princess versus king.
Okay, I guess we will decide that now then.
I think these
are very similar to Triple X Extra Strong Mints in the UK. They taste exactly the same, except they're not quite as strong. I love strong mints, they were really great. They'd like blow your head off. They're great for clearing your sinuses out. Okay, so is the King Mint better? Let's find out. Slightly smaller.
Is this going to be like a fight that breaks out in the comment section of this video?
I hope so. And I also hope that it's in Dutch so I can't read it. I say that the Wilhelmina one is better.
Ooh. Well, there you go.
It's got slightly more kick to it. And I like strong mints, so. Cool. Yeah. Most of that was fairly dull. I've got to be honest.
What were your favorites? Like, I guess your top favorite.
That cookie is
that
amazing.
Cookie. Das cookie.
Yeah, it's like, that's German. But it's, there's a brand, you can get some of it over here. I can't remember what it is, of the European butter style cookies. Can you remember what they were called? The kind of butter biscuits.
From here? That you could get?
They have them on the store shelves in some stores. They're very popular in the UK though.
Like, we have them like very, like, we'll even have like the store brand.
Well, you remember the one that's kind of the flat butter biscuit with the big chocolate block on the top of it, which usually has like a picture of something on it?
Oh, those are French. Those are the,
I can't remember the name of the company that makes them, bro.
But yeah,
but thicker.
Yeah, those are French, those ones that you see on the...
Yeah, they're pretty awesome.
Yeah,
I like them a lot.
They are pretty nice.
Yeah, so that was the best. And the worst... What is this? What are you doing? Man, jeez. How are you even a country? Oh, no. Mm-mm. Do not put cheese in wafers ever again. Ugh. Blech.